Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
I guess we should kind of reframe.
Yeah, should we do a quick recap here?
Yeah, Scott, you want to kick us off?
Oh, sure, I'd love to, Michael. Yeah. Thank you for...
Maybe I should just tag.
This is a woman you've been stalking.
Yeah, there's a woman you've been stalking at the gym, and she's about to come into the studio. Done. No. you,
Well, I've been wanting to put together a,
yes,
a local
out of nowhere,
female
you
bodybuilding
started,
showcase.
Yes, out of nowhere, you came up with the idea of doing a local female bodybuilder showcase on this here program. And in my mind, I was like, that doesn't really make sense to me. Why are we just doing this out of nowhere?
I loved it.
I guess there's something to it, but I didn't really see where it was coming from. And then it all came clear to me is that you have... There's this one girl that you have a bit of infatuation
it's
with.
Not her. An infatuation.
Mike, for a month now,
words.
It's all you've talked about. Is that not the definition of infatuation?
Well, you've thrown out words like specimen.
It sounds like I'm in love with her. I'm just fascinated by
Look
her.
Look up the
work
definition
ethic.
Of infatuation, please. I think I'm using all the right, word properly.
Fine.
For a month, you've done nothing but talk about her. I would say that's being a bit infatuated. around here, this and that. She's a bodybuilder. She's, what did you say? She's
an intense but short-lived passion or admiration for someone or something.
Perfect use of the word. Perfect use
Stuck
of the
landing.
Right.
You've been infatuated with this girl for a month. You've brought her up to your girlfriend. You've brought her up to us. You've called her a specimen. You at the gym, you watch her work out.
I don't watch her work out, but she's in my line of sight, so
you
I see it happening.
You know where she leaves
her
property. Don't
start splitting hairs now, dude. Don't.
Well, you make it sound like I'm just sitting there, like,
no,
leering at her.
Do I need to fill in the whole rest of the sentence? While you're working out as well, Michael, you look over and watch
you,
her
yes.
work out.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like you're standing in the corner with your hand on your pants watching
well,
her work out.
Well, that's what you make
although
it sound like.
Because there probably was some of that.
No, there's not.
You didn't go home at any point.
God, I'm exhausted
and enter in on like the RedTube search engine bodybuilder.
I go through a million different genres. I get bored real
quick. Well,
anyway,
she's here. She's here. Her name is Toni. We've tracked her down. She's here. Mike found it. We said Mike should approach her in person, which he didn't do originally. He tracked her down via social media and then got her to agree to come on. But then he did approach her at the gym. They got a great picture. It's up at JSS98Rock on Twitter, your Twitter handle.
Yeah, Facebook. It's pretty much everywhere.
Mike.
She's out in the hall. Get her.
Bring in Toni Perdikakis.
How do you say her last name? She's, I don't know. She's Greek.
Toni P.
Oh, I can't wait. I'm going to go in for the hug. I'm going to see if she's receptive to the hug.
Okay. Oh, God, here she goes. Oh!
Mike's so nervous that we're
going to
throw him
under
the bus.
He has every reason to be nervous. Every reason. Is. Ladies and gentlemen, Toni Perdikakis.
Why do I think I know her? Gosh, she's so familiar.
She's got one of those faces.
Can I get a hug?
You know.
Are you a hugger? Oh, she's a hugger.
Come in for a squeeze. There we go.
Oh, she's so strong.
Go ahead and grab yourself
she's
some
so
headphones.
Oh, she
get
smells wonderful.
And
her
she's
hair.
Ready to work out.
There we go. Yeah, look at that outfit. Man. Oh, her arms are.
So I just put this on.
Yeah. Right there, just
yeah,
like
we're
that.
We're live on the air as
and
we
hop
speak.
Up onto that.
Mike, get that microphone right in front of her.
There we are.
All right, here we go.
You have to understand, my sweet, this has been weeks in the making.
Are you kidding?
Or should I say months, depending on how long Mike's
no,
been stalking
not.
You
no,
from the
first
distance?
First off, let me clear the air here. It's not been stalking. It came up because I've been fascinated with how hard you work
there.
Out at the gym.
All right. Toni,
it's,
hypothetical
it's a marvel.
For you. How would you feel at some point, hypothetically speaking here, not an actual thing, to find out maybe someone's been watching you from the parking lot? Would that weird you out?
I mean, maybe. It depends kind of what he looks like.
It looks like that.
Say
no,
like that.
I jokingly said that the other day that it's not true.
No, but listen.
I'm not a psychopath.
First of all, Toni, welcome to the program.
Welcome
thank you
sweet.
For coming. It's
thank
a pleasure
thank
to have you.
Thank you for having me.
You are beautiful. Your body is insane. You know that. Your hair.
Thanks.
But you got to know that when you're at the Merit and you're working out, you're drawing a lot of attention.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a normal-looking chick.
No.
And you're not there to, like pussyfoot around. Like, we've seen some of your videos. You're not like
you're
one lift, two lift, 20-minute story. One lift, two lift, want to go get a muscle? I mean, you're just, like, going ham. I mean, just throwing to
get off the machine!
Yeah,
like
intense.
Killing it.
Yeah. I mean, I to do.
Whoa!
Am I
no, 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 sorry, no. Sorry.
I have stuff to do.
I like her.
She even goes ham in conversation.
You're there that's to get fun. Some stuff done.
Yeah, you guys were supposed to tell me the rules before.
Yeah, no dirty words.
I mean, I don't like to, I work out sometimes 3 to 4 hours a day. So when I'm there, I want to get it done. I want to get out because I have other stuff to do.
3 to 4 hours a day. That's working out quickly.
Yeah.
And is that every day?
Well, no. When I'm getting ready for a show, like right now, I do 2 hours of cardio and I train.
Okay.
As I get closer, I may have to go up to 3 hours of cardio.
Wow. Now, what is that car? I mean, I don't want to get like super worky outy here, but like, how do you do 3 hours of cardio? I would want to jump off a cliff.
Sometimes you want to. I mean, I have like my phone, my iPad. I'll people watch when I'm at the gym.
You're like Mike Anderson.
Okay, so it's two ways. Okay.
I will say I did. I peeped him. He was on the step mill yesterday. He was doing cardio.
Okay.
And like, you're baby. Peeping him. What'd you think? Has he got a good ass or anything like that?
No, that's why I'm doing it. I need an ass.
You can have some of mine.
Yeah.
Would you be? Oh, no, no. Hey, your nickname's Buns, by the way. That's one of your nicknames is Buns.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you're rocking out a tush.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing, you bounce a walnut off it.
Yeah.
A lot of squats? Squat low, squat heavy?
I've always had a big butt. I'm Greek.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Same, right there.
But then once I started squatting, it like went up in the air and it's like.
It popped out.
Yeah.
Like a couple of cantaloupes.
Absolutely.
You have to know that at the gym because of the intensity of your workout, you know, your appearance, you're just completely jacked, still super feminine. You got a butt for days. You realize you're the object of a lot of people, Michael's affection there at the gym. Do you know you had eyes on you?
No, I guess I just kind of mind my business. But I do, the one thing I have noticed, there are people that kind of follow me around the gym because they don't want to pay for a trainer. So they kind of, they'll like, hey, can I work in with you? And I'm like, yeah, I mean, if you're going to actually work in and not like just do whatever I'm doing.
And they just want to, they following your regimen to try to do what you're doing. That's hilarious.
I like to play with them. So like, if they do something like that, then I'll do something like really like, I'll do some plyo, like a ton of burpees and stuff. And I'm like, all right, let's go.
Oh, you'll try and burn them out. You'll try and fry them up.
Let's see.
Now, here's the thing. You come in here and you're smiling, you're beautiful, you're engaging, you're fun.
The listeners are into you, by the way.
For the first, Mike's, I don't want to make Mike sound creepy. This is not to make Mike sound creepy. But
Mike's
just
creepy.
In the course of the show, like, you know, he's been talking about, he's like, that chick was there again. I don't know, maybe we should get her up. She's so fascinating. She's so intense and... And he made you come across as like this. I don't know. I was scared,
tyrant, like a barbarian.
I was scared.
Like, you get in your way, someone's getting knocked out.
And I think it's just that's your gym zone, right? Like when you're, it's just the intensity that comes. Do you go into like a different, mindset a bit?
Yeah, I kind of zone out and I do kind of just put my head down and work because if not, a lot of people are going to talk to me.
Yeah.
And then an hour and 15-minute workout is going to turn into a 2-hour workout. And it's just like, dude, I'm hungry.
You got stuff to do.
Yeah. I mean, I'm a trainer. Mm-hmm. I compete. I'm also an energy engineer.
What the hell's that?
So we go into huge buildings all over the United States and we audit all of their lighting and water systems.
Oh, so you have a real job on top of all this?
Yes.
Oh, my
God. Oh, so she's also a genius. So that's cool.
Because like we thought you were just like a person. Because we said we were talking about how do you even get the time for all this? If you're working out that much, then you got a job, and then you personal train on the side. It's like busy.
I am really busy, but also my boss at the engineering firm is totally cool. He knows when I get close to a show. Like, you know, there's times I can only be in there like 3 or 4 hours a day.
Yeah.
So he's really supportive of that.
IFBB Pro Toni Perdikakis, am I saying that correctly?
Yeah.
Joins us on the program. Take us before we got to jump to sports. We're going to continue more with you. Tell us how the photo came to be from this weekend, because a week ago, Mike was terrified to get within 20 feet of you. Out of nowhere, I'm half in the bag over the weekend. My phone lights up, and I see a picture of him standing right next to you, grinning from ear to ear. Your girl, Rose is up
on his
fat, chubby shoulders near like a squat rack, and it seems like you guys are old pals. How did he approach you?
Well, when we spoke about coming onto the show, I was like, I have no idea who you are, so introduce yourself. And he came over to me at the gym on Sunday in the middle of the ice storm. Props. That's dedication.
Yeah, that's right, he lives right across the street. Don't give him that much props.
I live right around the corner.
I almost fell like 3 times, all right?
And he came up and introduced himself, and I was like, hey, you know, let's put something on social media, some funny picture. Because I had Rose with me. She's Jack. She's
genius.
From Colorado.
What did he say? What were his words?
Just, hey, I'm Mike.
Yeah, I was just like, hey, you know,
Hi, I like your body.
It was kind of like that.
You strong, hot. Hi. Your body good, mine not.
You hot, strong girl.
Photo, please. Touch you.
The 98 Rock Morning Show with Justin, Scott, and Spiegel. 98online.com.